Yes, I'm here. Do 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 do. Boop a doop boop boop. Boop boop a doop a doo. So my plan for today, that which lurks, is to ignore you. Completely ignore you. I'm good. Thanks. Thanks for asking. But to ignore you and instead answer questions from the Friday stream, which is what I said I would do on the Friday stream. So just trying to keep my promises and stuff. Afternoon, snugsy one. So normally I would be doing Tuesday, I would not be streaming, but yesterday I didn't stream. And then Tuesday, I normally don't stream because that is our team meeting. But we actually, I had some school stuff for Maxine that I had to do this morning. Yep, that's annoying. So I rescheduled our team meeting for Wednesday so I could take part of it and not have to miss Maxine's school stuff. So tomorrow, we're having our team meeting. And yes, I'm probably only talking to like two people here, but we're having our team meeting. Hold Hey, thank you very much, Skege Media. But we're gonna have our team meeting tomorrow and then pack. Try to pack another 100 boxes or so as a team. Q. Woo! And sorry, Yordick Myers. Apparently, whenever he jumps on to live stream, I jump on right after him. And steal his viewers. JDoc, I don't think anything's been done on that. We've had a bunch of fires as expected. They were just slow smoldering things that caught fire. The big one being the permission stuff and trying to get some issues resolved with the permission stuff. So I don't think anyone has looked at that. Do, 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 do. Let's see. All right, I'm up to 31 people here. I guess I can find some prizes. Ooh, Shogun Ship City Dry Dock Home. What? Interesting. Ornate Public Cash Chest. Okay. Heavy plate. Let's start off with this ornate public cash chest.
Hold on, Ben. Let me cover you up.
The important things. And also, I will warn you guys, both Maxine and my lovely wife are home. Oh, and thank you, Dinsu, for the resub. But they're both home, so I might get some interruptions here, more than just the normal people at work interrupting me stuff. Let's see, ornate public cash chest. Ornate public cash chest. Reset. Open. Okay, there we go. Bloop. It's the sound it makes when someone opens our door. Do-do-do. Let's see, we got Corsivius, A Night Owl, Brass Knuckles, 007, Pub Rules, That Which Lurks. You guys are top five. Dust Rider, Sagewise, sorry, six and seven. Just missing out. Let's see. So let me go pull up the questions from the Friday stream. Because my plan was to just do nothing but answer those questions today. Let's see. And I'm not answering all questions, because honestly, I don't know the answer to all of them, and some of them are just kind of low morale, so I'm answering all the high morale questions. If I get through these, oh, and thank you very much, Snugsy1. If I get through all these, I will be going to look at newer questions, stuff you're asking right now. Cloak, when are the new subscriber options / tiers coming in, and what are they? So that is something that Tassilo has been started working on. But he's easing back into working, so he's only working about like 15 hours a week or something like that, 2 days a week. So when they're coming on, hopefully soon. The real goal is to make sure that they're online and available like before we get into the Christmas season, like October timeframe. And I think we'll make that. What they are is not entirely set, but it'll probably just be some more money tiers and then have some extra benefits. Again, we continue to look for things that are new benefits you guys can have. So we're not taking stuff away from old players, but new benefits we can have that we can tack on to those. Let's see. Salty cheese ball, how long will the prosperity tools be in the shop? So, we might have answered this on the live stream. Yeah, so the prosperity tools that are in there, they're actually heritage. So these are, again, we probably need a better description for those. When we do, that's going to be a new thing you'll be seeing a lot more of. Sorry, reading, catching up on chat. God, and rings going off everywhere. We have a motion detector system for the front yard and the backyard. In the backyard, we have some swings up that are like chair swings where you sit in them, and when the wind blows just right, it sets off our motion detector back there, and my phone goes beeping every time. But anyways, the prosperity tools that are in the shop now are heritage items, which is something we're going to try to do with some of these items where we want to maintain the collectability of the old version, but we still want to sell it due to its functionality. So the heritage versions are no trade. So those may be there forever, but they'll just be the no trade version. So not as cool as the old ones, but still kind of cool. Hey, thank you very much, Taiki. Oh, I think this is horrible. Taiki, you were the first one. That means that Nubby Earwiggles was not the first one, and he broke his strength. For the love of all things holy, fixed range. If you're talking about the damage for range, there's actually a change going in the next build. Again, I'm going to nudge it in the right direction. There'll be another small change that goes out before. But the one that is being changed, the two things will probably change before I leave for my trip on Friday is, one, the additional damage per tick for charged shots will go from 0.35 to 0.33, I think. Again, we're talking, there's going to be like five or six very small things that all have some effect on, like they'll have effect on all weapon schools, but really the ones that are most impacted by it are the ranged guys. There will also probably be a small change to make ranged have a slower tick rate. Right now it's fixed. Everybody ticks up at the same rate if you're doing charged attacks, free attacks, and that'll probably slow down a little bit. I think it's like right now it may be at 0.18, and I'll probably move that to 0.20 for, as in 0.2 seconds versus 0.18 seconds for ticks. But again, it's not going to be any one big change that will fix ranged. The changes instead will come in about five or six little 3% here, 5% here, you know, 2% here type things that my belief is they will add up to be significant enough to help push range back, getting closer to the category of magic and, well, not all the weapon types, but pole arms and blades at least. Let's see. Legion of Myth, can we have corpses in different poses to place in the ground that can be dressed like mannequins? Also, eventually dress our vendors like mannequins. That's a great idea on the vendors, dress them like mannequins. Yeah, so we'll probably add a bunch more mannequin options. I'd already suggested to Star before the stream on Friday, if we really wanted to make some money, we could sell mannequins in sex poses for you guys. I didn't mention that on stream because I knew what Star's reaction would be. But anyways, I know there's at least a couple of sex dungeons out there, so I think they'd be big sellers for a few people at least. Let's see. Cleo dude, can we please... Maxine is on the front porch. Mojito's a little extra defensive today. The neighbor had a tiny puppy, a Maltipoo. It was like a puppy, like an actual baby Maltipoo. All right, bud, I'm going to shut the door and lock you out. That'll teach you. But it was like a 2-pound Maltipoo puppy. We brought it over here so Mojito can play with him. Mojito did not appreciate the puppy. let's see. Cleo dude, can we get please get one day buffs for music and pubs from players dancing and playing music? I like the idea of having like pub buffs. Basically go into a pub and get a buff because, I mean, again, I think we've talked about before, but like I grew up playing Dungeons and Dragons in my basement in various towns. Howdy, I Star Strider. But yeah, I mean, that's one of those things. I love the pub. I love pub ideas. There's going to be some new buffs coming on. One of the new things I'll be adding, I may not get to it this release just because this release is going to be crazy. Because again, trying to wrap up shipping this release, which falls a lot on my shoulders, and then also I'm out of town for part of it, and then also Maxine starts school at the end of it. I'm gone for, pretty sure that's next. Yeah, so next, let's see. Yeah, I'm gone for a week, I'm back for a week, and then I leave to go to Vegas for Syndicon for the last of it. So I'm out roughly 2 weeks of this entire release, which is only a 4-week release, I think. No, it's a 5-week release. So, but anyways, what the thing I was getting to was the thing I've been talking about that I want to get in there is, again, trying to come up with ways. This comes out of talks from me and other people on the team about ways to make boss fights meaningful. We continue to try to improve loot. I think you guys probably heard Beezus talking about adding some more mossy handle type stuff that's going to be coming up. We continue to make the crafting better. But another thing I'd mentioned adding that is feels like low-hanging fruit and something that has a lot of benefits. And I'm not sure if I've seen it in any other game. But right now you can go and get like multi-day buffs from, you know, obviously from pots have them. But then there's also a few puzzle areas where you can get multi-day buffs. Making that something that when you kill a boss mob, you get a multi-day buff, or it opens up a small chamber as a reward for a multi-day buff. So that, you know, there's an additional reason to go kill them. It's not just about the loot. You also get some other buffs for it, too. Let's see. But anyways, I'm hoping to get to that for this release. House of Mengar, the leaderboards are nice, but can we please include a lifetime category? So we could include a lifetime category, but the problem with that, we'd have to build up a caching system, and depending on what it is and how the stats work, sometimes we wouldn't be able to properly cache things and represent it well. We can't really do a query for lifetime, because like building that chart, even though we build it as an offline process at night, it would still be pretty time consuming and beat the crap out of the server that it runs on. I do like the idea of having the lifetime. We just have like week, day, hold on. I'm blind. Leaderboards. While I'm explaining to you why we can't have lifetimes, Bobby just messaged me to say I already have lifetime, we just don't have the actual data. Okay, so he is building it. That does sound like he's probably building it, caching it properly for most things. We just don't have a year's or a lifetime worth of data. We only have data for a smaller amount of time. So maybe a yearly is the suggested option. Let's see. Would it be possible to get a filter box for the spell book? The spell book, not the crafting book, not the quest book, but the spell book. Not sure what that would be for. Don't understand that one, why you'd want that. Let's see. Babanzai 28 asks a question. This one brings up what has been eating up a lot of her time. Is there a way to prevent kindred from moving specific items in a guild chapter house? So this is, as you guys know, we did a major overhaul on the right system for decoing and some of that had some negative fallout. It seems it's a handful of people who are really negatively impacted by it. We've got one more data migration that we're going to be doing to make problems less, but I think some of it that's remaining is probably going to stay how it is, just because that's how it needs to be going forward. So we will see. There's a few more fixes coming in. Sorry, dog. A few more fixes coming in, but it's getting pretty close. But honestly, that's one of those things I haven't paid that much attention to. I have so many irons in the fire. Is that the phrase? So many irons in the fire already that I just basically delegated that to Lord Suttleton and a few other people on the team to talk it through and figure it out. But anyways, I believe it is close. Let's see. Reading down the questions here. I did not pre-read any of these. When will the NPC merchant be fixed in the Obsidian Trials? And also, when you zone out, you insta-die. By design, there's a cost to the Obsidian Trials. I don't know on that. I've heard the merchant broken in the Obsidian Trials thing before, but I don't know what the cause is, and I forget who has that on them. But I'll make sure I'll push that push to get that fixed. Let's see. Let's see. Crafters have some leaven and mastery, or with mastery and R68. How about some leaven for the rest of the crafters? Agriculture, fishing. I know fishing got a decimal point. Cooking as well. Yeah, that's, again, we're doing a chunk at a time here. That's what I'd been saying, was we would probably do this one big upfront thing, and then we'll start pushing, you know, maybe one or two schools a release, rather than making it try, you know, claim we're going to get it all done in one release. Scammer on Good Game asks, if you make attenuation cap change with a scene, can we finally kill UT? Thanks. Apparently not a UT fan. Not the Longhorns. Of course, everybody's a Longhorns fan, right? Am I right? Hook 'em. That'd be upper tiers. But so the attenuation did change, as you guys know, but it seems also some type of bug crept in. Sorry, hear a small child screaming in the distance. But some type of bug crept in, that so it's not properly losing the attenuation. So I think it lets you like double screw yourself right now. I think you can get 2 million real quick, but then it kind of like locks you out for twice as long, and it's not as big a deal. Huge bug, Snugsy One says. Yeah, I didn't even hear about that until just today. So I put a blocker on Lord Subtleton for that. Let's see. Do you plan to add tanning and smelting celestial baths? Is that the, what you're calling the town, what are the things, the pot things in the pound town called? Those things, the blessings, the shrines, the things. Are those celestial baths now? Devotionals, yes, that's it. I don't know that we're adding any more devotionals. Let's see. But yeah, I hadn't heard that come up that much. The kind of already have the problem that everybody just like throws all of them in there, and then they yell that they can't, you know, they need more building slots or whatever, or NPC slots maybe. So yeah, so we'll be looking at it, but I don't know you guys need any more, but if we have only part of the crafting area represented, then maybe we can just go add it in, so some buffs give two, so we don't have to have add even more buffs. Akinma, I see your question there. So the OP-ness of charged attack itself, that's, I mentioned earlier, that's actually the thing going on. That's primarily the charged attack. Is primarily a bow OP thing. So there's going to be two small changes going in shortly. The one going in the next patch, not the one that just released, but the next one after that. That'll probably be out for tonight or tomorrow. That is, it increases the time it takes to charge for bows. And then it also decreases the amount of damage you get per extra tick you charge up. Now, each of these is only, you know, in the couple of percent range, but again, there's going to be five or six of these little micro nerfs that will largely be hit or aimed at getting bow back into line. And no, I can't increase everything else to be as powerful as bow. And the bow is kind of one of those things that for a long time it wasn't OP, it was normal. And I think it's you guys figure out how to play better. Crafted items get a little bit better. But, there's not a ton that has changed. It's just you guys have been continue to figure out how to min-max things even better. Yeah, the bow probably got OP when I did a while back. I dropped the charge speed from like 0.25 to 0.18, I think. Which is fine for other weapons, but for bows, just a combination of things makes that really OP. Skull Grinder. I saw this during the stream, and I didn't know what to think. Chris, about to decommission an EMC Isilon and VNX, along with a Cisco UCS. Interested? It's all free. I don't know what any of those things are. I think that's a Dell EMC. I think these are Dell things. These are Dell server things. I would have to go Google again. I do our IT. I manage some of the servers in addition to all the other crap I do. But those sound like new and sexy things. And which means that I'm totally unaware of what they are. So I don't know what those are. If it's free, we'll take it. Skull Grinder probably isn't even out there, but I guess I probably need to contact them. For those who are wondering, I did get the new server and I have it upstairs smoke testing. The other good news is I managed to fix the machine that died completely. All four nodes died. I had an extra chassis, empty chassis laying around, and I was able to pull the nodes out, plug them into the new chassis. So now we have 2 4 node backups. So I'm gonna go get that one racked here soon, hopefully before I go on my trip. And so we'll have multiple backups. It's not a 1.8 to 2.0. Again, yeah, we're doing a, it's going to be a multiple little things that will be bringing down Bo, rather than doing like one big, trying to come up with one big fix for it. There's some other stuff. That's one of those where the pendulum just swung a little too far on the speed of charging and the power that you gain from charging. Because for the longest time, nobody did it. I mean, I watched the metrics for it and nobody was doing charged attacks. But now the all the big hits and the high DPS guys, a lot of them are they've got the charge attack down. That kind of always been the plan. That was another one of my designs that I think people just didn't get until later on. But it, you know, it's one of those things, if you want to get into the rhythm of doing it, then you actually get a significantly better DPS of just, you know, charge shoot rather than just letting the auto attack bloop, 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 bloop. Now, for those who are thinking it's free, Taiki is saying something. Blind shot gives 100% crits from the front with charged shot currently. I don't know how that's possible. I'm going to have to go look at that. But anyway, so the idea was that, yeah, if you are willing to put out extra effort rather than doing the auto shot, then there's some benefits to it. Now, there's still some big benefits from doing the auto shot besides the whole convenience and ease thing. There's some skills. You guys know you can kind of overlap some skill charging stuff with those. I'm going to go look and see what blind does. I'd had people tell me that, and I wasn't able to repro that blind. Oh, you know what? Maybe I was looking at blind, not blind shot. That just does melee damage plus blinding shot damage. Let's see, so it does add a stat. Okay, so it adds the negative dexterity known. And it reduces combat parry modifier. I'm looking at the stuff, so okay, so you can get minus the skill level divided, it's minus 10 plus skill level divided by 5, those two things added together, times blinding shot debuff power. I wonder if blinding shot debuff power is set wrong. Uh-oh, is list on? I see some 133s coming in. Thank you, Snugsy, and thank you, Griffler. I'll do, you know, not full respects, but I'll do, I can do, once all these little chunks of ranged balance goes in, I'll do the thing where you can unlearn any of those, any skills in ranged for 100% experience return. Blind Sun Tree. Okay, so it is blind, not blinding shot. Got it. All right, let's see. So this one does three effects. One is damage avoidance reduction. Got it. Check. One is dexterity. How much is that removing? So that's doing skill level divided by 5. Plus 5 times negative attunement. So let's see. So that could actually get pretty big. That could get up into the, you know, 20 to 30 base. So if you got like a 125, that'd be a negative 30 base with negative attunement. If they don't have good sun resistance, you can get 2 or 3. So you could get like maybe negative 70, negative 80 dex. Is that what's causing it? And maybe there's some bad math with having a super low dex. I wouldn't think it'd move it to 100, though. Aha! So, weapon crit bonus. It's only giving negative 0.05 weapon crit bonus. And that should be for them, not you. It only works with archery. What? It's only archery. All right, I'm gonna have to go look at code then, because it's gotta be the dex portion of that. I'm not getting through my questions, guys. Attempt stun clear, nope. Attempt knockdown, nope. Calculate crit chance. Okay, here we go. Source, dexterity, got it. If you're a crossbow, but that should be the source is getting it, not the target. Divided by, so it takes your dex divided by 800, okay. Let's see, dodge chance. So the target dex divided by 2 gets added to the, but that's the dodge chance. Yeah, I'm still not seeing how this could happen. All right, well, I'm going to have to step through this. I'd heard somebody say that before, and I thought they were just exaggerating, to be honest. I will take a look at that and see what I can figure out. Yeah, and that's what J-Doc said, too. It's not like archery is the, you know, The only thing, I mean, there's some places where archery is really good. PvP is one of those places where it's really good, because PvP is frequently a one-on-one affair, and it's very practical for that. Now for creatures, again, you got to have room to move around. You know, it doesn't do as well against lots of targets, so it's not like it's archery is the only thing. Archery does feel like the only thing when you see people hit for the damage they hit, but it's not even the best DPS. Because, again, it doesn't have as many good ranged multi-target stuff. Yeah, and what Difficult said, it's really the problem with archery is the peak damage and how that appears when you're PvPing against somebody who's an archer. And that's kind of what I'm trying to address. It's broke, Chris. So broke. Okay. So every hit will still be for 500 minus a couple percentage points. The change is they'll be able to shoot that 500 shot less often is the one that's coming in the very short term. Yeah, and it's the charge shot crit. I'm aware of what the problem is. I log, I don't keep every single hit out, but I log metrics on lots of different stuff, including like max hits and high hits. Anyways, let me get back to answering questions. The real reason I'm here today. Actually, let me give you guys prizes. The real reason you're here today. You guys ready? Everybody raffled up? Raffled. I think you're probably raffled up. Oh, and this will look like nothing to you guys. But I've managed to find some low-hanging fruit global optimizations that it can break things. So I only put it in a handful of levels that I tested very thoroughly. So I basically picked the starting level, Solus Bridge starter, Solus Bridge outskirts, and then Novia. I figured that's like map 1-2, and then Novia, everybody obviously goes to Novia. Vesper, I believe you. I just need to get to a place where I can debug it. He's offering to show me the crit thing. And I'm not going to be able to debug it in this client. Oh, but anyways, so the... Well, it doesn't look as smooth on the stream. But anyway, so the thing I just put in that's in this patch as well is there's some serious optimizations for the first couple scenes. And then Novia also got some optimization. So it's a constant 60 FPS. Again, it doesn't look 60 FPS on the stream. It looks glorious on my screen. But anyway, so it should be better frame right there. Now you can see that it's actually 60 FPS all the way around. But anyway, so there's optimization. So I'm going to be propagating this change to a number of other scenes. It was just too risky to sneak into the others. So this is actually helping both graphics and your CPU work as well. It greatly reduces complex scenes. So the next build, I actually snuck in a way that anybody who wants to can try it out on any scene as I sit here and work on testing stuff. Maybe I'll share that with you guys so you can go and start testing. But there's basically what it's doing is it's a quick way. When you're in a scene, it takes lots of different objects and intelligently batches them up. But it actually bakes them together. So it actually increases your memory footprint. And it's very much a trade... memory for performance thing. So I only do it on machines that have 8 gigs or more of RAM. But anyway, so now those first three scenes at least will be crazy fast. And again, it'll be a command line thing that you'll be able to toggle soon. Not this patch, not the one that just came out, but the next one should have that in there. And give you a pretty good frame rate boost in most scenes. Yeah, I'm on 32 gigs on this machine. The server that's sitting upstairs is 192 gigs. Huh? What do you think about that? 192 gigs DDR4 ECC? So far, so good on the new server stuff, though. Let's see. Get it back to a good time of day here. Ah. Let me get back to... Oh, no, I was going to do the raffle thing. That's right. Close giveaway. Pick winner. Faux Soup. Congratulations, Faux Soup. And I just had somebody thank me for always working so hard. Next week, I will not be working hard. Look at that frame rate. Oh, it was 200 frames a second. And that's the other thing that's going to be a little bit of a challenge with the optimization I have going in is I have trouble testing it. There we go. I was going to say I have to get into a pot and get down to a place where there's a bunch of decos. Of course, some of this is lagging due to decos loading. But anyways, this type of stuff should actually be much better frame rate. I've mentioned it before, but the largest performance issue we have is the CPU, the render loop that is single-threaded in Unity. And this basically does a lot of, what the hell is that? Oh, God dang it. I know exactly what that is. So I did that. Apparently there's some object here. Hold on, let me cry to the team there. All right, so good news. The patch has not been published. So this is when you import objects. Hey, guess what? This is caused by a Unity bug. When you import FBX files, that's the model format, there's some settings on it. One of them is scale. There's like 20 or 30 settings on it. One of them is scale. And there's other ones on there. The one I went and batch edited and set a bunch to read write, which shouldn't change anything else. Guess what? It changed something else on some of these things. So I've got to go and track down which ones were also had their scale change. But the thing that's the bug is if you go and you batch select them, you click the button for changing the read write flag, it shouldn't change anything else. But for some reason, the very first variable in it is the scale, and it resets the scale value there and resets that, even though you don't touch it. But it resets the scale. That's what causes this right here. Now, I saw this, and I thought I got all the ones that were wrong. Apparently, though, there's something in here. I don't even know what the hell that thing is. But whatever that thing is, it's got a 100-to-1 scale going on. That's not a city property marker. What are you? Hold on, I'm taking screenshots for people. So anyway, so I'm probably going to have to cut my stream short here. So let me give away... I was actually coming here so I could give away the prizening. Oh look, I can get to my mailbox, fortunately. So let me see. Oh yeah, who won that last one? Is that faux soup? Don't raffle yet, people. 1 second. Faux soup, what's your in-game name? It's not faux soup. All right, I'm gonna give away something cool here. I'm gonna give away three, count them, three. Give them away back-to-back mannequins. So I'll do that here just in a second, and then I gotta log early. But let me get this thing out to him. What was I giving away? Ornate. There we go. Enjoy. All right, let me reset this thing. Reset. Three. Woman Atkins. I'll give away three female mannequins. It looks like this is probably a rock that was right in here. All right, I'll have to come check out this map in a editor build so I can see what's going on. Let me get that going first. You guys can enjoy me staring at the screen for a minute while you raffle up. But yeah, sorry, I'm gonna have to cut things short and go deal with this because it's absolutely my problem to fix. Let's see. Alright, that's done. I'm going to have to open Unity in the background, which may... oh, that's not what I wanted. There we go. We have not formalized the streamer program stuff. But yes, I will still send out... Look, there's Burning Toad. Admiring my rock. I will still send out crowns people. Under the old system. And there's a lot of stuff going on that you guys will probably hear about here shortly. And you'll understand why I've been so busy. Crowns. It's fun being mysterious. Bam. All right. Well, that went pretty quick. Oh, no, it did not. Anyway, sorry, guys. My brain is now thinking about how to fix this problem and not about you guys. I will be answering more questions. I'm going to do a lot of streaming tomorrow is my plan. I'm not sure how we're going to work it, but we are doing packing and a team meeting here. I may show some of that on the live stream. We will see. But I got to go fix this stuff now, and you guys will get more than enough of me tomorrow, I'm sure. So let me, hey, thank you very much, Radiant Woodlander. Check your whispers. Uh-oh. Careless whisper of my good friends. Yeah, except Elwyn Moon, there's not a good way to do it. What we really need to do is there's only, 1% of the objects in the game use this screwed up scale value. We need to go and we need to fix all of those, but that involves importing into art and or into an art program and scaling it in there and then pulling it back in. And really what it involves is Unity fixing that bug, which I didn't actually identify until today, but I went in and reproduced it and was able to reproduce it. All right, so let me go and do giveaways now. You guys have all raffled up, right? I'm just going to click three times to get three names and then give out three things here. And I'm going to log off and go fix these massive rocks so we can get a build done. Oh, yeah, I'll slew up. Yeah, look at my fortress. Oh, man, there's more over here. Look at the size of that thing. Is that good? You like that? Oh, and thank you, Griffler, and thank you, Snugsy1, thank you, Radiant Woodlander. But see, it's only like very, very, very rare. There's one object in this, looks like right there. All right, I'm gonna have to go figure out where exactly that is. Lame. Quick. Okay, well, I'm going to be logging to go fix that, but let me do the giveaways now. I'm sure you guys have all entered, so I'm going to be closing. And pick winner. One. Rhinos. Hold on, let me get to my house so I can send this junk off right now. My house in here. The funny thing was I was standing here for a long time. I didn't even notice because we do back face calling, so you only see stuff from one side, which reduces your draw calls by 50, or your draw poly count by 50%. Yeah, I was in there for all that time. We didn't even notice it. And let's see. Let me try Rhinos. Let me turn that thing off. Let me go buy the three mannequins. One. Two. Three. Rhinos, you get mannequin number one. Bam. All right, doing the next one. Next one goes to pick winner. Vegas BLT. Ah, congratulations, Vegas BLT. You don't have to tell me your name, I know it. Let's see if I can keep this secret. Yeah. Still covered up. And then number three goes to... What? Okay, I'm gonna do one more then. Rhinos, I'll send you one too. Send you a second one. Rigged, I agree. Who is Rhinos? I don't even know who Rhinos is. Pub rules, there you go, okay. So Rhinos, congratulations. You apparently are the big winner today. And get two mannequins. Oh, man. Pub rules, what's your name in game? Morgana pub gear. Got it. Oh, except I can't spell, apparently. More. Gonna. Pub goer, not pub gear. There we go, okay. Grats on that. Guys, sorry to cut the stream a little bit short. It's been more than an hour. But obviously I have some things to deal with here. But I'll be fixing these up and hopefully we can get out of build later tonight. Again, this is a one-click fix, but the challenge is finding it first. But anyway, so guys, thanks so much. And I will see you tomorrow. Again, I'll be streaming probably odd hours tomorrow, but I'll be on stream. Uh-oh, iStar Strive sent me a bit. What was a bit for? Hey, thank you very much, Prison Bound. I don't see iStar Strider. He must have scrolled off already. But again, guys, see you tomorrow. I'm going to go raid somebody here. And I will get back to answering the questions when I start on this tomorrow. Answering from the Friday stream, as I said I would. And again, sorry to have to cut things short. But you'll get plenty of time for me tomorrow. Also, tomorrow is a good day to watch because not only will I be doing prizenings and streaming a good chunk of the day, I will also be doing some special, some stream specials that are new and unique and very exciting. I'm not exactly sure what they are yet, but they'll be awesome. Trust me. But it'll be something, it'll be kind of like Lord British-y style, Lord British birthday style thing. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, I think we got 5, oh no, we got 4 active people right now. I'm going to do a random full 4. Roll 4, and the result is a 1. iWacko, congratulations, sir. We are rating. Got him. Guys, again, thank you so much. Tomorrow's stream will be better, interesting. We'll have lots of stuff to talk about. We may have some, you guys might have some crazy new questions on some things that is very exciting. And we will be shipping boxes and lots and lots and lots of stuff. Lots of prizes tomorrow. Lots of stream question Q&A done because I'll probably answer, do stream stuff while the other guys are packing. Is at least one possibility. But again, lots of stream specials and stuff. So be on there tomorrow. And let's go raid iWacko. And guys, again, sorry for the screw up. But obviously, I've created a small mess in the game. So... I need to go fix it. See ya.